Stewart, and Alvin Meyer. You will have 10 minutes to present your Veterans Focus platform, and another 10 minutes to answer four questions that have been collected by the Veterans Affairs Commission based on the State of the American Veterans study that was done last year by the University of Southern California. And then there's a little buffer for follow-up on the issue. Timekeeper's been assigned. David's sitting here in front of you. We'll give you the 5-minute, 3-minute, 2-minute, 30-second warning. So do you have any questions? Okay. Please go ahead and do the presentation.
If it's okay, I'm just going to stand here so I can be closer to the audience. Thank you so much for hosting all of the mayoral candidates here today. It's really an honor to be with our veterans here in San Francisco. Thank you so much for your service to our country. We all depend so much on your leadership, your dedication, and the work that you do both here in our country and abroad. So thank you very much. I have also the honor of serving our city and county a little over the last decade. I started out on the San Francisco Board of Education and now serve on the Board of Supervisors. I represent a very dynamic and challenging district, which includes the South of Market, Tenderloin, Treasure Island, and Mission Bay. I represent the poorest residents of San Francisco, and as of 3 years ago, I represent the wealthiest zip code as well. Almost every single adult homeless shelter is also in the district I represent, and almost every single tech company you've heard of is in the district that I represent. Close to 80% of all of San Francisco's residential and commercial development is also happening in the district that I represent. And so I spend quite a bit of time working at issues around housing and land use and helping to shape the future of San Francisco neighborhoods. I'm proud to have led the initiative to make San Francisco the only city in the nation to make community college free again for all of our residents via Proposition W. I'm also proud to have fought for, negotiated, and won more affordable and middle-income housing than any other member of the Board of Supervisors over the last 8 years. And I've also been the author of a tenant protection ordinance in 2015, after which we have been seeing a drop in low-fault evictions throughout our city here in San Francisco. I'm also the district where Source to Plowshare is a resident, and I'm proud to have worked with them on several homeless and veteran housing here in our city, on Treasure Island at 150 Otis. I am absolutely committed to continuing Mayor Ed Lee's promise to get to zero on veteran homelessness. Homelessness is a crisis that exists here in our city, but not just in San Francisco, it's cities across the nation. And it's something that began to emerge in the 1980s when we began to cut funding to HUD. In fact, prior to that, HUD's budget used to be larger than the Department of Defense, and we used to have more public housing units than people on the wait list. We absolutely need to invest in subsidized housing, and having worked with market rate developers in the last 8 years, I get why. Housing, market rate housing simply does not pencil out for the poor, the working class, and now in San Francisco, even the middle class needs to be subsidized to be able to stay here in San Francisco. I do believe that one of the most urgent questions one of the most urgent questions pressing San Francisco today is who gets to live here? Who gets to live in this great city with our progressive laws and our programs and policies? And we have to ensure that San Francisco is a city for all of us. I did just want to go straight to Q&A. And also, I'm going to take questions from the audience as well.
We weren't planning on, no, we have four of these four.